While addressing leaders and stakeholders from Bunyoro region during a sensitization and popularization meeting held at Kontiki Hotel in Hoima City, Deborah Charasime, the executive director of Uganda Warehouse Receipt System Authority, observed that farmers in the region lack market information and access to affordable credit.
We are looking at how we can promote marketing for these commodities, because the good markets we have are looking for volumes and volumes of good quality. So how do you do that? You have farmers aggregating together, and then you have storage facilities with capacity to clean, dry, and improve on quality or enhance quality, and then the people or the markets that are interested in volumes of good quality will have those as service centers. All the time, instead of running around the villages looking for small quantities, just come to a licensed and certified warehouse, pick their good volumes and of good quality.
Currently, Kakumiro has 18 storage structures, Hoima District has 32, Hoima City 6, Chikube, Chiriandongo 6, Masindi 28, while Bulisa has one storage structure. Charisime observed that most warehouses in the area are dilapidated.
The difference between warehouse receipt system and cooperatives is the similarity. We are not looking for new things, but we are bringing the operations to be, we are proposing operating differently. Cooperatives use concentrate on their members. I do cleaning and marketing and everything for my members. We are actually asking cooperatives to open up and provide a service generally to members and to non-members. And in the old cooperative arrangement, the cooperatives would buy from members. Here we are telling cooperatives, be the unit or the conduit through which members can trade through you. They don't have to sell to you, but they can sell through you. We have keen interest in the storage infrastructure across the region. You know, this is an area where I used to have the Bunyoro Growers Cooperative Union, Kakumiro Growers Cooperative Union, all old, currently dilapidated and, you know, not in so good organized state. We are looking at the private sector also, where they can contribute as far as our requirements are concerned in terms of storage infrastructure. That's why we've been with the Business Forum. The opportunity is to invest in storage in this area, in this region, and embrace the warehouse receipts.
According to Andrew Chirunji Byakutaga, the Bunyoro Kitara Kingdom Premier, the region lost about 260 billion shillings due to poor post-harvest handling.
In 2018, this amount of maize would contribute about 15% of the total GDP of Bunyoro. I picked on maize, but I wanted to give you an example. And that's what I found out. That is the amount of money Bunyoro was going to lose because of poor harvest handling. Of course, the GDP is 0.5 over a billion dollars, but it will increase in a short while, in a few years, 2-3 years. Bunyoro will be contributing about close to 50% of the total GDP of this country.
As a country suffering, because our farmers are not organized in groups, but marketing at individual level, no support for supplying individual in Kenya. Individual, it's costing our farmers. We have to organized to supply as an entity, as a group. One individual is supplying because of supplying maybe poor products. Zibi, no support for our maize because of an individual.
Bunyoro region currently has a storage capacity of 1.8 million metric tons. Farmers in the Albertine Graben region have been encouraged to embrace the warehouse receipting system. Report by Ambrose Nwagaba for the news. Okay.